Welcome back to InDesign Basic Training, and in this video we're going to do a run-through to a page layout. And I'm going to fly pretty quickly here. Here's an example of something that's finished, and there's not very many items on the page. Just like on this page, there's like 9 different items, shapes and images and text and things like that. I have some pictures that are set into place. You might be putting a placeholder picture, so you might have to replace it if a client wants you to switch a picture or you have to manipulate it. Here's an example of a stock photo that I initially used and then colorized it for the client. You'll notice the end imagery in Photoshop. I recolored it, reconfigured it, converted it to CMYK for usage. Okay, so I have all the assets and stuff in order usually. At least for now, placeholder types of things as well. All right, let's go through and create a new document. Now you notice I'm going to fly through this pretty quickly. I want to print document, letter size, and only one column just so I can have my margins on the outer edges. I want the margins to be like 3/8 of an inch, 0.375, and no slug. Bleed area. Bleed, incidentally, is for commercial type of purposes, or if you have where you can print out a page larger and you trim off the edge. Okay, desktop printers, I'm going to go ahead and click OK. Desktop printers have a margin that is non-printable. If you're going to use all of the page, you can't go off of the edge. It does not contain a bleed, so you have to plan for that sort of thing. Okay, I'm going to be using the rectangle and the frame tools here. I'm going to use the type tool to convert my objects to text frames, or otherwise you can use the type tool as well for that purpose to make a type tool. I'm also going to use the selection tool. Okay, I like to work larger to smaller and things that are underneath and then overlap on top. So with some good planning, we can manage this. All right, rectangle tool first. I want to make a whole picture, background picture. All right, and you'll notice that I have a bounding box here. It's highlighted with the little nodes on it. It's blue just because in our layers panel, you notice that I have a blue color. Okay, if I have other layers, we can change those colors, no problem. Usually in InDesign, you don't end up with very many layers like you would in Photoshop or in Illustrator, but layers have their purpose. These little nodes indicate that it is live, or in other words, I'm working with this particular object, same way as you do in Illustrator. You're going to see a lot of similarities between this and Illustrator, but InDesign, as a page layout program, it is designed for production, and so that's what makes it so fantastic. Okay, so you'll also notice a cross, an X across this object. That means that this object is empty. So anytime you see that, it means it's empty. It doesn't have an image and it does not have text in it. All right, I'm going to make a headline, and I'm going to use the type tool, and you'll notice the cursor, the tool has changed the look of it. It is a little cursor, and when I make that, it makes this little blinking line here. That means that I've got live text and I can type something in. Okay, I'm going to go, this is my headline. This is my headline. Okay, we're just going to do some basics here. Line. Gosh, I'm a terrible typist. Okay. And I'm going to make it so that it's really quick. I'm going to do these objects and convert them later. Click and drag to make a byline area. You notice that I go from one side of the margin to the other. Makes it easier for me to line these things up with each other. I can do something that text that is aligned center, and they'll all be centered perfectly. And okay, so I need another text. This is going to be for body copy, or the main part of the article. And again, nothing in it. And I want a page number at the bottom here. So I'm just going to make a box. Sometimes you draw these things and they're not perfect. You go back and straighten them out. Now you'll notice I say perfect a lot. Some people, my clients, say I'm picky. Personally, I say I'm precise. And that means that, but for graphic designers, it means that your precision is very important. As a graphic designer, you need to be precise, and you need to pay attention to detail to make your layouts that much better, and it makes you much more marketable. In fact, I've won some awards for my page layout, so yes, I am picky. All right, so using my type tool, now first I want to get one more thing, this frame tool. I'm going to do an unusual shape. Holding down my shift key, I can constrain the proportion. So I'm going to put a picture that's centered. So I want to select that and move it with the selection tool. And you'll notice InDesign builds into it a way to center things. If you just kind of push it over and line it up, it's telling me right where the center is. There are tools for alignment, which we'll get to it in other tutorials, so don't worry about it. Now, most of these things are text, but I'm going to get to that just in a moment. First of all, I want to actually place my pictures. So clicking on the picture box, I'm going to go under File, Place. You can start to use your key commands. Command-D on a Mac, Control-D on a PC. All right, I have a picture that's actually prepared, this watercolor one. Open it up. All right, and I want to see it is not going all the way across, so I'm going to make it a slightly bigger to get inside of the object. The whole concept behind the page layout is that you have all these objects and you put something in those container objects. And to get to my picture, see, I just have the object itself, which contains the picture. But I'm going to undo that. To get to it, I go to the direct selection tool, or I can double click with the regular selection tool. Double click. And you'll notice there's an orange bounding box instead. That means that I have a hold of the picture. I'm going to go to the top corner, and holding down my Option or on a PC Alt, then hold down your Shift key to constrain. Okay, again, we don't want to stretch or squash our pictures. Please don't stretch and squash your pictures. That's the sure sign of an amateur. Okay, so this is rather dark, so I want to bring this down to being a percentage. Okay, you'll be surprised that it looks light here, but when the ink hits the paper, it becomes very dark, actually. The other picture, I'm going to go ahead and place that. File, Place. Okay, and I have a stock image here. The client has not given approval yet of this picture. I want him to see what it looks like. Since this is on top of everything, then this little disc also indicates that I can click, and it's another way of getting to the image inside. All right, this needs resizing. So another way of resizing is you can go to the control panel, and with that selected, go to the reference point and click in the middle. Also, my 100% here, this percentage size, I have the constrained proportions. Always constrain your proportions. And I could choose something much smaller, 50%. Well, that's too small. So if I, again, hold down my Option and my Shift key, or my Alt and Shift key at the same time, and click and drag, then I can pull that right out. Also, you'll notice when I hover over it, there's a hand tool, and I can click and drag my picture down, or I'll use my arrow keys to place that. We'll go over that in all these other tutorials. Yes, I still have a watermark. Leave that there. Always charge your client for them paying for a stock photo. You do not give that to them because they could get sued for it. You don't want that. All right, next I want to place my text. So So I'm going to use the type tool, and for this next one, all I have to do is click inside of the object, and it converts it automatically. By, okay, Professor Tennant. Okay, if you use a capital, then you would use it throughout every article in your publication. If you start every one of them with the lowercase, make sure they match. All right, this last area here, well, not last area, I need placeholder text because I don't have the text here yet. So I'm going to go under type, go with placeholder text, and it looks like Greek. Okay, well, we do call it Greek text, or in our industry, or dummy text. It's actually ancient Latin, and there's a story about it. You'll find out about it later. All right, I need two columns because that's really difficult to read. So I'm going to click the object itself, leaving the type tool behind. Go under Object, Text Frame Options. And I want two columns. I'm going to leave the gutter to the default because it's pretty normal as a size. And it splits it in two. All right, and lastly, my text here at the bottom. Click on that, and I want to put a page number. All right, now I'm going to start to kind of manipulate the text a little bit. Having my cursor in, I don't even have to highlight the text itself. I could go to the control panel, and you'll see here the text alignment center. If you don't see it there, you could get the paragraph panel, go under window, type in tables, get you to the character and paragraph and all kinds of wonderful stuff, panels. So that's centered. Well, it's not really centered. I want to show you something. If I zoom in, my bounding box or my object goes from the page trim edge to the margin. I want that to be lined up at the margin. Now it will be actually centered. You see that, okay? All right, now I need the text to wrap around this, so text wrap is in order. There's a panel for that. We'll learn all about it. Now I can wrap around the bounding box, which gets all of the text to be scared out of the box, but I want it to wrap around the shape, so there's that capability as well. I also want to push the margin out, and it's an outset. So then it doesn't look too bad. And then if I double click in the where the text is, it will automatically jump me to the type tool. And again, double click on my headline. I want that centered. Now don't center body copy, like this area here, don't center, but your headlines and things like that can be centered. Now I'm going to make this bigger, and in the control panel, I do have access to sizes and typefaces and all that. So you can manipulate the typeface and a lot of little details that we'll learn about in subsequent tutorials. Okay, so last but not least, I want to preview it without all these crazy margins. Don't worry, they don't print. So under the last tool in the toolbar, we're in normal view right now. We want preview, and there's what it will look like printed. I have 6 items on the page is all. All right, hang on to your hats because we're going to go to other tutorials to learn all about this stuff. This was your overview.